Good afternoon, everyone. We are in the home stretch of theCUBE's live coverage of Fal.Con 2025, our first day here. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight, alongside my co-host and analyst, Dave Vellante.
Everybody's partying. Not us,
oh,
we're working still.
There's wine is flowing, the hors d'oeuvres are out. I would like to welcome two new guests to the show. We have Todd Cramer, Senior Director, Security Ecosystem Business Development at Intel Client Computing Division. Welcome.
Yeah. Great to be here. Looking forward to it.
And Lori Zwilling, Senior Director, Software Product Management at Dell Technologies. Welcome, Lori. Great to have you both.
Thank you.
So, Todd, we're going to talk about third generation AI PCs.
Sure.
What makes a third generation?
Yeah, AI is everywhere. It's at your PC. I think we're coming up on our third generation of client PCs. And so when you think about it, you know, the industry's been running AI for years, machine learning. They can do it on the CPU, but it really could impact the user experience. So really, the GPU is capable of running machine learning in a higher compute fashion, but now we got the NPU, the neural processing unit, capable of running deep learning kind of algorithms, and really the specs, the memory, the performance has gotten to a point where you don't need to run AI all in the cloud. You're going to run that compute where it runs best in a blend across client to the cloud. So I think that market is evolving. I think IDC, Canalys, and others, it's about 41% of PCs sold have an NPU, so they're AI PC capable. It's about, in 2025, about 150 million devices. So we're getting to that crossing the chasm, the tipping point, and then as our partners, Dell and other OEMs, put it into lower, not premium SKUs, mainstream, you're going to see every PC is going to be an AI capable PC. And so that's part of it. The other part of it too, I'll say, is we work with the software ecosystem to create the market, right? You don't just have a PC and it runs AI. You've got to work with the security ISVs, any ISV, to say what model, what AI, what feature would make sense to run on client. And that's where you get things, privacy, faster latency, access, we're at a security event, access to all the data you couldn't send to the cloud to fire a detection in Crowdstrike. So really it's a making of an ecosystem, but it starts with the compute, moves to the software, and yeah, that's
so what I at. What I love about my Dell AI PC is, in the NPU, is the battery life. I'm gonna start there. That's the best feature.
Right.
It's awesome. But what's the link to security at the endpoint?
Right. Well, you know, I think we're better off now with AI and security, really for a number of reasons. I mean, first of all, AI is going to be more proactive versus reactive. I mean, this morning at the keynote, we heard all about, you know, the coming of highly automated AI, and yeah, the adversary is going to take advantage of that, but so are our security solutions, which are going to be better able to prevent, detect, and mitigate, you know, anything that's coming down the pike. It's also real time. AI is on 24/7. And that's going to have two wonderful benefits, one of which is it's going to detect vulnerabilities and be able to mitigate them much sooner, as well as if a breach does get through, the mean time to resolution should also be reduced, you know, preventing those threats or those actions from moving laterally and damaging a customer's environment. The other aspect is user behavior baseline capture. When you think about it, the intelligence that we have in the age of AI to really capture how an end user is using a PC and what is normal for them. And then over time, what is not normal for them, right? You know, whether that's logging in from locations that they don't normally log in from or different file access that's unusual for that end user, AI is going to be able to pick up on those things. And there's this other aspect around locality. We have customers coming to us at Dell asking us, for help, how can they run AI on the PC? And there's a number of reasons, one of which is security. You know, they have sensitive data, especially, you know, small language models. They don't necessarily want to expose them to the cloud or to third-party APIs where they're more vulnerable, right? They want to keep them resident to the device. Some of our customers are air-gapped, so it's an absolute requirement, you know, that they have this capability. And back in March, Dell actually released a solution called Dell Pro AI Studio. And this is a solution that brings a secure toolkit to market for our customers to get to market quicker implementing their AI solutions on AI PCs. And how we do that is we provide pre-validated models, vulnerability tested, file integrity checked, that they can consume, and then they can create their applications, roll them out across their whole PC fleet much quicker, secure, and there's another benefit, they run cheaper. The other thing we see happening for our customers is several months into running AI in the cloud, they're realizing it can be expensive and it's cheaper to share the load on the AI PC.
It was interesting, we were just talking to Adam Myers, and I think the Dell deal with CrowdStrike goes back at least 2 years, maybe even 3 years now, and he said, we've kind of locked down the client, the PC, the endpoint, and so the adversary has now moved on. Now they're going to identity. So what are you guys seeing? What does the data show? I mean, it sounds like you're having some success. Do you have any sort of maybe concrete examples that you can share where you've had some successes? What are you seeing?
You're talking about AI for security?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that, you know, right here at the conference, we've got some demos running early models with Fal.Con Data Protection. That's their DLP platform. And most DLP in the industries kind of have a bad rap.
Yeah.
Poor efficacy, false positives. You know, it analyzes for corporate users data exfiltration or sensitive data that shouldn't go outside of the enterprise. And that's done with a rigid rule-based approach, right? Literally, it's got to know the rule that it says username, there's a username and password, or that's sensitive data. Those rules pick it up. But what we've done is, they've done actually, they've run an AI model that runs on client, uses the GPU, and is able to analyze documents for all sorts of classification. It does a semantic search, it's natural language, it finds it better, and I think CrowdStrike on some of the early data, it's about a 3-to-1 better advantage versus old rules-based DLP, letting AI do its thing on client. You know, I think George Kurtz said, you know, we're going to fix DLP. What I'd say, running AI on client on these AI PCs is actually fixing it, right? It's clear the data's there. So there's lots of stories like that that just show if you run AI in the right place, it can do a lot for you.
And Lori, are you seeing this across Dell's fleets? Are you seeing a noticeable sort of change in the data? I feel like a lot of users don't understand this. I think they think, oh, wow, AI PCs is all in the future. I go, battery life and security, let's start there. I'm in, how much? And then all that other good stuff comes. But what are you seeing in across your fleet? I mean, you have so much data at Dell.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. You know, I think the way I want to respond to that is really a healthy PC is a secure PC. Mm-hmm. And that's really what a lot of our data is around, is how healthy are our PCs. And you know, Dell's doing a really good job. We have unique telemetry, telemetry that's very visible, whether that's security telemetry or manageability telemetry. We make it visible to our customers. We meet our customers where they're at in their portals of choice, whether it's Intune for manageability, whether it's CrowdStrike for security. I mean, these are the key aspects. The other thing we heard in the keynote today is that this is a team sport. I mean, that sounds like a canned phrase, but it's really authentic in the sense that, you know, we can't all do this alone. We need to be partnering with best in class. We partner with CrowdStrike, with Intel for very good reason. And I do want to give you an example of something that we're doing and we're even demoing here at the conference. The level of integrations that we have between Intel, CrowdStrike, and Dell are unlike anything else in market. You know, customers come to us and they want to be able to see what's happening below that lid, right, from a security standpoint. And the way they can do that is through the telemetry that Intel and Dell will share, and then we share it through that CrowdStrike platform, that console. It gives the customer one window into the world of their security, and then you know we will surface to them whether it's a BIOS impact detection or whether it's a firmware compromise or an indicator attack. These are all very rich data, very unique data, and that we surface that they can mitigate. And I believe it was a demo. It was a fancy bear rootkit demo, right?
Yeah,
that the team
yeah,
showed, yeah. And they demonstrated even how that aligns to the MITRE attack sequence. Right, so I think for me, the take home is manageability is really key.
So that's an integration story, mm-hmm. I think.
Between, yeah,
that's right.
Sure.
Between Intel, Dell, and CrowdStrike ecosystem doing the work, create that single pane of glass or visibility in one place. Is that Is that right? That's where the engineering takes place?
Yeah. I mean, we each have different attack surfaces, how we talk about it on a PC. You know, we do things in silicon that help protect the firmware, the secure and protected boot. Dell's got pieces in the firmware. They've got Dell Trusted Device. You move up the stack. We build things for Windows, Windows 11, virtualization-based security, isolation, and then the EDRs like CrowdStrike. So, you know, each hardware and silicon feature is engineered for a corresponding software security feature. So it's all kind of done by design, so to speak. But then getting it all integrated into one system, security system of record, there's no bigger platform than CrowdStrike. What are they up to, 23 modules, right? People like that consolidated stack approach. And they like the fact that Intel, Dell, and CrowdStrike are working to make sure these toggle, these switches, when you're running an Intel vPro Dell machine, you've got actual configurations in CrowdStrike that activate, make it better, make it run faster, et cetera.
And Lori, is this what customers had been hoping for when they see this kind of integration? And as you said, the team sport, companies working together, is this what they had been requesting?
Yes, I mean, they're requesting best in class security, period, right? And then it's on us to deliver on that promise. And yes, we have the most secure PCs in market because of this multi-layered approach that we take, you know, by partnering with best in class partners. And the integrations are absolutely key because you can't protect what you can't see. And that's exactly what our telemetry integrations do. It's what Dell's proprietary solutions, Dell Trusted Device, we have others that are, you know, leveraging our own unique telemetry and surfacing up for mitigation.
Yeah, I'll add too, is like when we help innovate the solutions at Intel and Dell takes them to channel, there's lots of performance testing. You know, big enterprises want to know what's the efficacy, what's the performance, what if I have other workloads running on that AI PC? That's what Dell does, right? They've set up these PCs, these vPro devices, these applications, and benchmark it. That's the way enterprises buy. It's not come buy it, you've got to show the data, and that's what Dell does with an enterprise environment.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, Todd, because you know we work very closely with Intel to test our workloads, our AI workloads across XPU, you know, at the CPU, GPU, and now the NPU as well. So you mentioned battery performance; we're very focused on that,
awesome.
And making sure that our customers have the best, you know, if anything, a faster PC than they had before with AI.
You know, back in the day when I was at IDC, one of my technical mentors said, look, if you want to always ask a good question, ask what happens when something goes wrong? How does recovery occur? What does that process look like? So when you think of things like the blue screen of death,
sure,
right? You guys have to figure out how to work together to get customers back online faster. How has that evolved? What are you guys doing? What happens when something goes wrong? How do these systems work together to recover?
Yeah, I'll talk about the Blue Friday incident, right? Intel vPro is a chip level KVM recovery solution. And you know, it's been deployed for 20 years and its day in the sun actually really came during that Blue Friday incident. We worked closely with CrowdStrike to help document that as a formal recovery tool. And you know, companies that ran vPro and were able to activate, were able to rebuild the OS in that situation and save millions of dollars, right? And so, that's one example of recovery, and we're also trying to get that technology easier to deploy, right? We've got integrations in Intune. We've announced here you can get it in Fal.Con for IT. So if you're using CrowdStrike security and manageability, you can be inside of that console, you can activate that vPro capability, and then we've also got that in Dell Command Suite and Dell Management Portal. Mm-hmm. So really it's meeting customers in the tool they want. And that's one little contribution we have, is that chip level recovery, and then you know Dell offers many more things on top of that.
Yeah.
You know, so, go ahead,
please. I was going to ask about supply chain, because that is top of mind for all CISOs. What are the two of you, Intel and Dell, doing to ensure that these AI PCs have integrity from the entire manufacturing process through deployment?
Yeah. Sure. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so Dell and Intel, we work together to secure the devices from the factory to deployment. I mean, that's the scope we're talking about here when we discuss supply chain. And you know, there's a number of things that we're doing. I'll give you my first example. We capture a manifest of the componentry and we cryptographically bind it to the device before it ships, such that when the end user receives it, if anything has changed, let's say malware has been injected, a component has been swapped, the technology is going to pick up on that and and it's going to flag that as an issue. So that's an example. Some of the other things we do, you know, we ship our devices with Dell Trusted Device. I mentioned that a little bit earlier. So that's looking for, you know, firmware, BIOS level tampering. Chassis intrusion is a great example. You know, you might not know that somebody opened the lid, but it will detect that that indeed happened. And we have good old fashioned physical security. Customers can get anti-tamper tape, right? And then it's very obvious then when there's been an intrusion. But I do want to mention secure component verification is one of our solutions that customers in North America, and you can have that on-prem, which is wonderful if they're air-gapped. We also offer that worldwide in the cloud, and there's an additional benefit as well. Many of our customers are working on their zero trust framework, and they can have the benefit of device attestation on top of user authentication because of this certificate that comes along with the PC. So, you know, Dell's really, you know, best in class when it comes to its supply chain, and these are just a few examples of our the unique solutions we have.
Yeah, I'll add a little bit to that. You know, it's also boils into procurement for that AI PC. You know, in today's political climate, we actually offer a SKU, Intel Assured Supply Chain. And so you can buy and ensure that your silicon was manufactured entirely in a Western-friendly geo, right? Silicon gets made in Malaysia, Vietnam, Europe, North America. Governments, financial, they're going to want to buy that PC that you can cryptographically verify was constructed in a Western-friendly geo. So, you know, there's little twists on all of this from supply chain to procurement. Lots of fun.
That's a SKU, that's genius.
Yeah.
I love that. Wow, that's a value add right there. That's who came up with that idea? They should get a bonus.
So, finally, looking ahead, what should security leaders understand about this hardware-assisted approach? What do you want viewers to leave this interview with?
Well, I think we're just working hard to, you know, these, like when you think about a device, it's got about 30 hardware security features on it. Most IT administrators don't understand all the different things it does. So we've got a big initiative at Intel to just raise the visibility with our work in MITRE. You know, get people to understand it. Treat your PC as a security control, just like your software security. You need to. It provides defense in depth. So I'd say from an Intel perspective, that's one initiative we're driving.
Yeah. My message would be, don't forget about the PC. Right? We all know that security is a multi-layered defense mechanism, defense in depth, that's what defines it. And the PC is at the base of it all. It comes with hardware, software, its own inner network. I mean, we must secure it. And customers, you know, they need to know this. And oftentimes, adversaries can run very stealth underneath that cover and go undetected.
A good rallying cry. There's some excitement going on here.
I just say, you guys have done some good work from silicon all the way up and through the PCs and software, so congratulations. I've watched this partnership evolve and it's for the better of all of us, so thank you.
And Dave's battery life in particular.
Yeah, for sure.
He thanks you for that. Excellent, yeah. Well, Todd and Lori, thank you both so much for coming.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I'm Rebecca Knight for Dave Vellante. Stay tuned for more of theCUBE's live coverage of Fal.Con 2025. You're watching theCUBE, the leader in enterprise tech news and analysis.